Hello. We are happy to announce the Digital Pāli Reader is completed and ready to use in your web browser. To start, go to digitalpalireader.online. The Digital Pāli Reader, originally created by Bhante Yuttadhammo, is a tool that includes the Pāli canon and related scriptures and has multiple interactive dictionaries to facilitate reading. It enables immersive study of the Tipiṭaka and the Pāli language at an advanced level. The DPR is used by Buddhist monks, scholars at universities around the world, and laypeople for study at home. This is the welcome screen. Here you'll see the daily Buddha Wachana, which is a daily passage, and can be a nice way to jump right into a text if you want. This button opens the sidebar. In the sidebar, you'll see three main tabs: navigation, search, and tools. In navigation, there are two ways to navigate to texts. There are quick links and the hierarchy. With quick links, you can type in shorthand notation to find texts. This info box shows you how to use this notation. So for example, if we type MN13, it opens up Majjhima Nikaya 13. You'll notice the cookie notification. You can accept this to remember your preferences. With the hierarchy, we can explore how the text is divided into sections and subsections. You can select a set and book. The MAT buttons allow you to select Mula, the root text, Atthakatha, the commentary, or Tikka, the sub-commentary. Here is the book we've selected. If you click on it, the index of the book and all its subsections will be displayed. If you click this button, all the subsections will be written out in full, combined on one page. Each of these drop-downs contains the subsections of the section selected above it. Just like before, you can click these buttons on the right to display all the subsections of a section combined on one page. To view the individual sections selected at the bottom of the hierarchy, click here. Here are the history and bookmark menus. You can press the B key to make bookmarks. When we click on a word in the text, it sends it to the bottom pane into the DPR analysis. The analyzed word is broken into parts. Words found in the Pali Text Society's Pali to English Dictionary, or PED, are shown in red. The PED definition is shown in this space below. The blue words are from the Concise Pali to English Dictionary, or CPED. Words from the Dictionary of Pali Proper Names are linked to with a green N. Numbers underneath the PED words indicate multiple definitions of that word. This word breakdown menu lets you choose different ways to break up the analyzed word so you can find the breakdown you are looking for. The C button shows paradigm charts for conjugation of verbs and declension of nouns and adjectives. The analyzed word will appear red in the chart if it is in that paradigm. The pencil button allows you to edit the spelling of the analyzed word. These arrows go to the next or previous word alphabetically in the PED. History shows the words you have looked up. These side buttons open up this dictionary pane, a conversion or transliteration tool, a text pad, a translation tool, and a conjugator. This button opens up the context menu. The context menu gives you quick access to various features. For example, you can go to the next or previous section of text with these arrows. This goes to the book's index. The MAT buttons go to the root text and commentaries. You can switch between the Thai and Myanmar/Burmese Tipiṭakas with the capital M and T buttons. Notice variant readings are shown in the text, which can be toggled on and off in the settings. These icons open side-by-side English translations of the text. If you click on these diamonds, it sends a permalink to the clipboard. When you go to the permalink, the chosen portion of text will show a green diamond next to it. In the Search tab, you can search for words in the texts. The search box accepts words typed in Belthuis or Unicode to give letters diacritic marks. You can look at this info box for help with Belthuis. For example, if you type period M, it writes a nigahita, or the M with a dot under it. If you type two A's in a row, it writes a long A, or the A with a bar over it. When you click search, you can stop the search with this red button. You can click on different results of the search to see what texts those terms are found in. The RX box lets you use regular expressions to search for patterns of text. This dropdown allows you to choose where you want your search to take place, be it within multiple sets, books in a set, a single book, or part of a book. The check selects all or deselects all. The Tools tab gives you access to dictionary searches and other resources. We can type a word into the search box using Belthuis again. This dropdown selects what dictionary you will search. You can also use the DPR analysis tool here. Words not found in any dictionary will appear black in the DPR analysis. The advanced options include regex again and a fuzzy search. When your search term does not appear in the selected dictionary, you'll get a few suggestions of what you may have meant. When you click fuzzy search, you get many more suggestions and approximations of your search term. Full text allows you to search for a term that appears within dictionary definition entries. And start of word only allows you to search for all words that start with your term. Pali language resources includes useful links. Then we have the buttons at the top of the sidebar. This button brings you to the welcome screen. This button allows you to install the DPR for offline use. Google Chrome is recommended for offline use. Select all the components you wish to download and click OK. You will see a progress bar begin in the sidebar. When it's finished, you will be able to use the downloaded components without a network connection. You may also install the DPR as an app by clicking here. This will add a shortcut to your device as well. The Help button will bring you to this video. This button will open up preferences. Here you will see general settings, layout, and text displays. In text script, you can choose to display the text in Roman, Thai, Devanagari, Burmese, Sinhala, Bangla, or Telugu script. And this button collapses the sidebar. Press the question mark key for a list of keyboard shortcuts. Press the feedback button if you'd like to contribute comments, criticisms, questions, bugs, or anything else you'd like to share. You may also email feedback to digitalpalireader@gmail.com. Thank you for your interest in the Digital Pali Reader. Thank you to Bhante Yuttadhammo and all the hardworking volunteers who have brought us this tool. May all beings be happy.